In this video, we explain what balanced and unbalanced cables and connections are and how they work. An unbalanced cable contains two wires and has two connection points at either end. One carries the audio signal and the other carries ground. Unbalanced cables typically contain shielding that helps prevent interference, but they can be vulnerable to picking up noise. A balanced cable contains three wires and has three connection points at either end. One carries ground and two carry the audio signal. The phase of one of the audio signals is reversed, so that when they are placed back in phase with each other by the input of the receiving device, any noise picked up along the way is cancelled out and signal strength is increased. This allows balanced cables to be used for longer runs and makes them considerably less vulnerable to picking up noise and other interference. The most common type of unbalanced cable is a standard instrument cable with a 1/4-inch TS jack on either end. These should only be used with instruments like guitars, basses, or older instruments that do not have a balanced output. When using unbalanced cables, it is advised to keep the cables as short as possible, since longer cables are more likely to pick up noise and other interference. In all other cases, you should use balanced cables, such as connecting microphones, line level sources, and monitor speakers to volt. Balanced cables come in form of TRS to TRS, XLR to XLR, or TRS to XLR cables. If you're unsure whether your device has unbalanced or balanced outputs, check the device's documentation and use the appropriate cables. Note that using balanced cables with unbalanced outputs will work, however, you will not get any benefits over using an unbalanced cable.